The KR C5 is the first new controller in a completely new set of controllers that, in the end, will cover all our robots. But let's recap a little bit from the last week's webinar, where we talked about the KR4 and the SCARA robots, both new robots to the KUKA family. And they all come with, of course, a smart pad, as any robot does. But it also comes with a new KRC Micro and the new system software, which comes along with it. This is what the KRC 5 Micro looks like. And we are quite proud to say that it has already become a Red Dot winner for its design and for its features. So this is the motivation for the price. The KUKA Controller KR C5 Micro is the key element of the drive for dynamic small robot systems. The innovative cooling and airflow principles ensure reliable operation, even in the case of high ambient temperatures. Moreover, it paves the way for an extremely compact construction with many integrated functions and connectivity. The controller can be installed in different positions as a single device, but it can also be stacked or installed in a 9-inch rack with optional mounting brackets. A lot of words in one sentence. So let's dive into it and have a look what this actually means. Why do KUKA introduce a new generation of robot controllers? Well, of course, we want to secure the availability of the controllers over a long time on the market. That means that we, from time to time, need to upgrade the components which we use in our controllers so that they are available for a long time forward. We naturally want to minimize the complexity of the controllers, so we need fewer spare parts and fewer assembly parts to build it. We, of course, need to reduce our energy consumptions. That means that in the KRC5 generations, the drive stages are more energy efficient than compared to the KRC4. And of course, we need a platform where we can integrate our current and coming products and be open to the future, which means that from at this time, it is required that we change our platform for the controllers. All this gives us, in reality, a reduction of the cost of ownership over the lifetime of the robot, a smaller footprint, both from an environmental perspective, but also from a physical perspective in the cabinets. We can continue and develop our softwares and technologies on this platform, and of course, a product that is simpler to build and mount, more standardized, gives us also an optimized delivery time to keep it to you in a timely fashion. So this is the KRC 5 Micro compared to the older KRC 4 Compact. So as you see, there is quite a big physical size difference. In fact, the volume of the KRC 5 Micro is 70% less than the KRC 4 Compact. So that's quite a big difference. And not only the volume, as you see, but also the weight has gone down quite significantly, 9 kilos compared to 33 kilos, which makes it easy to handle, easy to mount. It also allows for a very flexible mounting. We will get back to that a little bit later, but in principle, you can mount it more or less any way you like. And it comes with practical mounting brackets. And of course, the connectivity of the KRC Micro is quite improved compared to the KRC 4 Compact. So if we have a look at what there actually is on the KRC Micro, it is a housing only available in IP20 at the moment. So that means that it needs to be built into some kind of cabinet because it's neither water nor dust protected. It's only IP20, which requires it to be built into a cabinet, as I mentioned. But it has its internal active cooling in terms of fans. There is, of course, an embedded computer with a safety controller. So like any robot controller, there are an integrated safety controller as well, which is TÜV certified. We have Ethernet interfaces on board. We have, as standard, digital I/O interfaces on board. And we do have also discrete safety signals from the start integrated on board of the controller. And of course, a power supply, which drives the 6-axis of the robots. If we look to the connections and start off with the backside, beyond the on-off button, there is the inlet for the power supply, which is 240 AC. And there is also an input for a 24-volt external UPS and a contact which allows it to daisy chain the external UPS of the battery. I'll have a picture explaining this a bit more in a few minutes. On the front side, we see quite a lot of contacts. So let's start off with Ethernet boards, which is a number of Ethernet contacts for EtherCAT, for the robot, and so on. In the next slide, we will go into what these ports actually are. There is a screen connection, which is a display port connection. There is also a connection for the smart pad. There are 24 volts in for supplying IOs, and there's a 24 volt power out for customer supply. That means that the IOs actually are free of potential from the customers, so we can use them directly. And there are on board 16 digital in and 16 digital out. There are also 3 fast measurement inputs, that is pulse inputs. And there is a UL lamp, it's designated. That's a bit confusing, but that's an American requirement for the US that we need to have an output for a run indicator for a lamp, which is required by the UL standard. There is, of course, a connection, a data connection to the robot itself, along with the 24 volt it requires. There is a contact for an external enable button to the system. And there are safe outputs for example, local emergency stop, which we perhaps need to forward to some kind of external equipment. And of course, there are also safe inputs where we can, for example, connect externally emergency stops. Furthermore, there are 2 contact ports for the motor cablings, for access 1, 2, 3 and to 4, 2, 6. There are 2 USB ports on board, pretty much like we had on the KR4 Compact. And there's a SSD slot for an external drive, if we need to use that one, and also a SD card input for saving extra data. So let's see if we have any questions so far. Not yet. So this is the data sheet of it. On the right hand side of the presentation, on the files, I've put up the brochure, and you will find those data here as well. It's interesting to mention that when the KRC micro is delivered, it comes with the required power cabling. There is an external battery box, which you see is a small box to the right of the controller, included as well. The plug package is included, of course. The mounting brackets are included. And there is a removable SSD card available and a 19-inch frame mounting brackets. But those two are actually sold as options or add-ons, if you like. They're not included in the delivery. But they are not neither nor absolutely required. Now, as you saw before, there were actually quite a lot of Ethernet interfaces on board. And these ports actually have different functionalities. There is, and they are called XF128. And as you see, the first one is the service interface, where we can connect a notebook for work visual configuration, diagnostics, and so on. The second one is the KUKA line interface, which is where we can do attach an external computer for installation and programming, debugging, and so on. The third interface is a link to the previous robot. That means that we can operate several robots through the two interfaces, X3 and X4, using a daisy chain scheme over a bus system. So, and these are switched, so we can have a lot of robots connected, and we need to just connect our external computer into one port. This is also required when we use software options as robot team or pick control, for example. So the X4 is the other link to the next computer. Then we have a Profinet port on X5. And as a slave, and one as a master, the XF5 and 6. And then there's a dedicated port for the KUNI, it's called. It's KUKA Optional Network Interface. That is if we want to attach, for example, camera systems to the robot controller directly. And then finally, there is also an EtherCAT interface on board. The KRC5 also requires a external 24 UPS. The UPS functionality is actually mostly in case of power loss to the complete system. The UPS ensures that the computer shuts down in a controlled way. And the KUKA controller is supplied with one of these 24 volts batteries, which is we see on the first left. They can be connected to one controller or even up to three controllers in parallel. Or if we already have some kind of UPS in the control cabinet where we mount our controller, you can of course use that UPS 24 volts instead, if you like. When it comes to mounting, the controller comes with four T-shaped brackets like the ones you see here. And this allows us to actually mount the controller in any way we like. We can, of course, mount it directly sitting on the floor or on the bottom of the cabinet, for example, with or without the mounting brackets of the feet, which they would act as in this case. We could also stack them on top of each other, and then we actually use the mounting brackets to create a small distance between them, so we have an airflow between each of one of them. Depending on how we assemble the mounting bracket, we could also have it standing on its side or mounted flat to a back wall of a cabinet, for example, or sticking out in a bookshelf mounting. That's pretty much the typical mounting where you see frequency converters or drives, for example. They are usually mounted in these ways. So the KRC5 can actually be mounted pretty much like a frequency converter would be inside the cabinet as well. Now, the KRC5 Micro, which we are talking about today, is dedicated to our small robots. That means the Agilis robots and the SCARA robots, the new SCARA robot we talked about last week. And this is a difference compared to the KRC4 we had before, because that the KRC4 Compact, which could actually handle the CyberTech Nano as well, that is not possible with the KRC Micro. So the KRC Micro is actually only for our robots in the small robot sizes, which is the Agilis robots up to 10 kilos and the SCARA robot. It comes with the smart pad, I've already mentioned that, and all these system softwares which we are used to using as before fits into our new operating system, the KSS 8.7, and can be programmed with the Work Visual 6. So actually it is a new controller, but from a functional point of view there has been no updates yet. This is more like a physical platform which allows us for future updates as it. So right now it comes with no new software features compared to the system software we have today on the KRC4. So the KSS 8.6 equals the KSS 8.7. Softwares can be moved between these two platforms, applications. And that means that all these software options, which are available to 8.7, are mostly already available on the 8.7 as they are on the 8.6. But we will talk more about the features of software in the next week's webinar, where we will dive in a little bit more in 8.7 and 8.6. Orange Intelligence.